7 and 8.
Not 11.
Okay.
I said 7.
So, my name's Robert Wittenberg, and I'm the state representative for this area. So I represent Berkeley and Huntington Woods and Oak Park and Ferndale and Pleasant Ridge and Hazel Park and Royal Oak Township. How many of you live in any of those cities? So just about everyone. All right, just about everyone. And so I work in, I'm in the government and I work in our capital in Lansing. So I work with other representatives and senators, and we work with the governor here in Michigan, and we help make the laws. So the rules, the laws that you and all your family members have to abide by. And there's some other things we do as well, but this is one of my favorite parts of the job. I get to come read to students all throughout the district. I'm sure you all know March is Reading Month, right? And I love to read. And so I want to come share my love of reading with all of you and just tell you how important it is to read and why you should be reading every single day. I wouldn't be where I am today if I wasn't a great reader. And it's something I have to do every single day for my job. I'm reading all the time. So it's so important, and that's why I wanted to come read with all of you. So what I want to do is maybe we'll read a story, and then I can take some questions afterwards. Does that work for you?
Yeah.
And then I'll answer any questions about what I do for my job or even about the book. So I'll get to you after, okay? So, oh, you're okay, just stretching. All right, good, getting ready for the story. All right, so we're going to read Yertle the Turtle. Who's read this book?
We
You haven't, okay. Oh, you haven't. Do you guys like this story?
Yeah.
All right, Dr. Seuss. So let's read Yertle the Turtle, and then we can take any questions. On the faraway island of Salamisan, Yertle the Turtle was king of the pond. A nice little pond. It was clean. It was neat. The water was warm. There was plenty to eat. The turtles had everything turtles might need, and they were all happy. Quite happy indeed. They were until Yertle, the king of them all, decided the kingdom he ruled was too small. I'm ruler, said Yertle, of all that I see, but I don't see enough. That's the trouble with me. With this stone for a throne, I look down on my pond, but I cannot look down on the places beyond. This throne that I sit on is too low down. It ought to be higher, he said with a frown. If I could sit high, how much greater it'd be. What a king, I'd be the ruler of all I could see. So Yertle the Turtle King lifted his hand, and Yertle the Turtle King gave a command. He ordered 9 turtles to swim to his stone, and using these turtles, he built a new throne. He made each turtle stand on another one's back, and he piled them all up in a 9 turtle stack. And then Yertle climbed up, he sat down on the pile. What a wonderful view, he could see almost a mile. All mine, Yertle cried. Oh, the things I now rule. I'm king of a cow and I'm king of a mule. I'm king of a house and what's more beyond that, I'm king of a blueberry bush and a cat. I'm Yertle the Turtle, oh marvelous me, for I am the ruler of all that I see. And all through that morning, he sat there up high, saying over and over, a great king am I. Until long about noon, then he heard a faint sigh. What's that? Snapped the king, and he looked down the stack, and he saw at the bottom a turtle named Mac. Just a part of his throne, and this plain little turtle looked up and he said, beg your pardon, King Yertle. I've pains in my back and my shoulders and knees. How long must we stand here, your majesty, please? Silence, the king of the turtles barked back. I'm king and you're only a turtle named Mac. You stay in your place while I sit here and rule. I'm king of a cow and I'm king of a mule. I'm king of a house and a bush and a cat. But that isn't all, I'll do better than that. My throne shall be higher, his royal voice thundered. So pile up more turtles. I want about 200. 100. Turtles, more turtles, he bellowed and brayed, and the turtles way down in the pond were afraid. They trembled, they shook, but they came, they obeyed. From all over the pond they came swimming by dozens, whole families of turtles with uncles and cousins. And all of them stepped on the head of poor Mac. One after another, they climbed up the stack. heck is right. Then Yertle the turtle was perched up so high, he could see 40 miles from his throne in the sky. Hooray, shouted Yertle, I'm king of the trees, I'm king of the birds, and I'm king of the bees. I'm king of the butterflies, king of the air. Ah, me, what a throne, what a wonderful chair. I'm Yertle the turtle, oh marvelous me, for I am the ruler of all that I see. Right. Well, they shouldn't even have to stack them all. Then again from below in the great heavy stack came a groan from that plain little turtle named Mac. Your Majesty, please, I don't like to complain, but down here below we are feeling great pain. I know up on top you are seeing great sights, but down at the bottom we too should have rights. We turtles can't stand it, our shells will all crack. Besides, we need food, we are starving, groaned Mac. Mac's down at the bottom here. You hush up your mouth, howled the mighty King Yertle. You've no right to talk to the world's highest turtle. I rule from the clouds, over land, over sea. There's nothing, no nothing, that's higher than me. But while he was shouting, he saw with surprise that the moon in the evening was starting to rise. Up over his head in the darkening skies, what's that, snorted Yertle. Say, what is that thing that dares to be higher than Yertle the king? I shall not allow it, I'll go higher still. I'll build my throne higher, I can and I will. I'll call some more turtles, I'll stack them to heaven. I need about 5,607. That's a lot of turtles. Right. But as Yertle the turtle king lifted his hand and started to order and give the command, that plain little turtle below in the stack, that plain little turtle whose name was just Mac, decided he'd taken enough, and he had, and that plain little lad got a little bit mad, and that plain little Mac did a plain little thing, he burped, and his burp shook the throne of the king.
Yeah!
Yeah. And Yertle the turtle, the king of the trees, and the king of the air, and the birds and the bees, the king of a house and a cow and a mule. Well, that was the end of the Turtle King's rule. For Yertle the king of all Salamasan fell off his high throne and fell plunk in the pond. Just the way they drew it in the book. And today the great Yertle, that marvelous he, is king of the mud, that is all he can see. And the turtles, of course, all the turtles are free, as turtles and maybe all creatures should be. The end.
I felt bad for the little baby who just above Mac. He was in second bottom.
Is that a good one? You guys have any questions? Raise your hand though. Let's listen up. If we have some questions, raise your hand and we got to listen nicely to our classmates, okay? So, yes. That's just the way the author or the illustrator drew them in here. So, have you ever seen a blue turtle? Mm-mm. Neither have I. I don't know. They just did it in the book. Let's go right here. Yes. I don't know. That was just what he was doing, but he got, you know, he ended up falling into the mud after all that, right? Because all the turtles should be equal. They should all be together. There. Yes. So there are other stories in this book. So there are other stories by Dr. Seuss in this book. And if we have time, we'll try to read another one.
Yay!
So, but let's get through some questions first. Yes, right there.
Who made him king?
That's a really good question. We don't really know. I think he just took it upon himself. But I don't know because we don't know what happened before the story started. So it's a good question though. Yes.
Why did he have to be so mean about stuff?
That's a good question. I agree. He shouldn't be, right? They should all be friends and they're all equal. Yes, back there. Yes, yes.
Greedy is being bad because if you're greedy, then you just want to do a lot of things and do whatever you want and stuff. I learned that from the lies Maleficent, the king who stole Maleficent's wings.
Oh, Maleficent, yes. Thank you for that. Yes.
I feel super bad for this baby turtle. It was the second
baby.
And they're all stacking up on top of the baby?
I know.
I feel bad too.